Hey guys, Dynamite Tiger here. We're gonna just try to do a kind of a chain of command chat slash podcast here on the fly. There's a few things that we kind of want to hash out, some brainstorming ideas, and what better way to kind of talk this over, and you guys can kind of hear both sides of the coin and see how we think we should maybe structure things, and then you can add your ideas and post your comments and stuff on the YouTube. I've like I said, my name is Dynamite Tiger, one of the admins. We've got Demon, Unholy Demon. He's our CO for First Bat and Alter. Sorry, XO and Alter's the CO. And then we've got Bobby is our CO for Second Bat Battlefield. So this is just Battlefield Chain of Command talk. What we kind of want to talk about today is how to best manage a squad larger than four players. As we all know, in Battlefield, you can only have four per squad in game. And of course, we've got your four separate classes. In best case scenario, typically speaking, you should have one person in each class. So to kind of paint the picture a little bit, back in Bad Company 2, we had much smaller squads, and they were, you know, anywhere from four to six members, but smaller, so that it was, you know, you'd basically have your one strong squad and a few guys, and because, you know, everybody's never can make it to every single practice and stuff, so you'd have your fillers and etc. And now we've moved on to the structure where you can have, you know, up to 12 members per squad, and you'd have one squad leader and then two SAs. And the SAs can then take on a squad in themselves. So in the ideal situation, everybody shows up to practice, you've got three four-man squads. Now we all know it doesn't work out that way, and that's where it gets tricky and difficult to try and manage a squad when, you know, you've got a guy who comes practice once a week and the other times he's not there, when, you know, you can't necessarily work on a lot more structured practices. And that's where competitive squads came in from before. I mean, maybe that is something that we need to discuss as well, bring maybe back some competitive squads for specifically for people who are on like every night, or who can be at every single practice without fault. But that's something in itself to discuss. So one of the things that I was thinking about is developing that each squad should have set fire teams, and a fire team being basically a squad within a squad. And that's one way to approach it. I'd like to hear what you guys think about that. If you think that's something that we should implement and say it's something that each squad leader should take into account and start setting those up, or what do you guys think?
There's two sides to it. As you said, you can have the fire teams and everyone working together over and over again, or you could also get everyone working together so you're not having the same fire teams over and over, if you get what I mean.
Yeah.
Just give them a bit of a break almost. So maybe like, say, one practice a week you're in your fire teams, and then the next day you're working with some other people just randomly, like, just so you're not doing the same things over and over with the same people. Kind of learn that everyone else in your squad, and you don't really want to feel like it's totally separate squad within your squad.
That's true too.
Kind of alienate yourselves, even though you're in the same. Like, I don't think you really want to do that. So maybe, like, we do two or four practices a week. So maybe two you work with your fire teams, and then two you just kind of go with random squad members and have some fun. Obviously, you're still going to work on some things like conquest and like how to capture points, how to defend, like all that sort of stuff, but just with other members of your own squad.
Well, you know, there's one thing that one other thing that kind of wanted to throw in a wrench in here is one of the things that I've been considering a lot lately is okay, so we're now getting to the point in the game where the majority of people have leveled up all of their classes to the point where they can use any one to a certain degree, but they've got ones that they use best, and Luton just put up a video just recently. I mean, even bringing up like, say, Battlefield Friends, right? Like, you know, like that last episode, they even bringing, you know, bringing into context, they're like, you know, it's the squad thing. Hey, you're part of the squad. We need you as an engineer. You're the guy, right? Like, is there something maybe should we implement that 90% of the time, if you're in a squad with VGs, you should have one of each class, and when necessary, switch out to an engineer to take out a tank or whatnot, but then switch back to what your class you're running?
I think for the most part, people are doing that anyways. Like, you'll obviously get the random times where you just kind of want to sit back and snipe. Hopefully you're not doing that with a bunch of VG people, but, you know, people are going to go in there as their favorite class, and usually when VG people are in a game, there's, like, tons of VG people in a game, so you're kind of trying to have a bit of friendly competition, so it kind of makes you actually want to try and win.
Right. And I agree with that. But then, you know, it's kind of hard at sometimes because as a clan, you want to be you join the clan because you want to work as a team and you want to be able to win as a team, right? Because it's all about playing the objective. But then, you know, there's times where if you're the kind of member who's playing like every night, you're starting to play with all different people from all different squads. And then, so if you specialize in an engineer, there could be 2-3 other engineers on there. I think that if just in general, if members just kind of at least keep it in mind, right? Because I do know, like, when you're just playing to play, like I'll play, like I played last night or whatever, I'm just playing something to try and maybe up an assignment, you know, complete an assignment or what have you. But to keep in mind that, hey, there's already 3 other engineers on the squad, why should I go engineer? Is something maybe to consider that maybe every member just needs to take this, think back to themselves, what if that's something they should be doing.
Yeah, it's definitely a good idea for everybody to actually think for themselves. But I know a lot of people, they don't actually do that. And that's why whenever I run with even some of my friends, like when I run with like Trevor and my buddy, you know, Kier, for some reason, they think that I'm the in charge, and I mean, I don't mind being in charge, but I'll usually tell them, you know, hey, there's a tank. Let's all switch to RPG and take it down, or if there's like a sniper, we'll all call it out, and someone will have to go anti-snipe just to take the sniper out. So usually, by having someone in charge, it definitely puts a better order on things, so to speak, if you know what I mean.
But right, and you know what? I completely agree with you, and that kind of brings up my next topic I kind of wanted to talk about was, and Luton has mentioned how even people have said to him, you know, every time I play with you, we seem to win, and it's because he actually takes charge and says, look, hey, guys, you know, and he's the eyes and ears for the squad. And not everybody is comfortable doing that, and I think one of the reasons why is because they don't want to offend anybody by leading them or charging them, telling them to what to do. And so I had thought of an idea is what do you guys think of if just under, just on, just as a courtesy rule, have, whoever is the highest ranking VG member in that squad at the time should be the leader, should be the one calling out orders. What do you guys think about that idea?
That's an interesting, baseline to put it at. Very generalized, but I mean, at least it gives it some. At least everybody has a general rule to play off of, you know.
Well, because the other thing you got to remember is that, you know, the highest ranking members are the ones who have been to the most practices.
That's true.
And so
I think that's a good idea, but it definitely you need to be able to switch around. So very much flexible, because obviously you're going to get a lot of new members that are going to come in that probably might have more experience at the game than people that have got the practice. Hey, you know, someday I'd like to become squad staff, you know, so let me demonstrate what I can do, kind of thing.
Right, but I understand what you're saying, but at the same time, if they've been to the most practices, they should have a better knowledge of strategies and tactics and which way to approach things than a member who's just joined. I mean, unless, of course, they came from a good clan and what have you, which is not the case most of the time. But I do understand what you're saying.
Yeah, I was, you know, just a bit of a suggestion, just kind of like, you know, help everyone out.
So, yeah, so if, you know, VG members, when you give out your comments and stuff, see what you guys think about that. That's kind of all I've got for now, if unless there's something else you guys want to kind of discuss. But I think that definitely trying to organize our squads is the most important. You know, I was talking about how everybody's kind of at the point where they're starting to rank. They're already ranked up and can use any class. For a while there, remember we had people who were not taking charge and switching to certain classes because they couldn't. And so we had a time there about a month or two ago where everybody was trying to level up everything, you know, get your levels up in the tanks and stuff like that. And you're still going to find that with new members. But now it's to the point where, you know what, now you can go back to your specialization and concentrate on what you're best at or what class you can excel in, and then switch when you need to. I think that as a clan, we can start to move back to that approach and start having people saying, you know, hey, I'm the pilot. I'm the best jet fighter on this squad. So I'll concentrate on that. Which brings up another topic too, is do you guys think it is would be a good idea to say that if a group of VG members or one or two members are going to say that they're going to concentrate on a vehicle that round, that they should be in a separate squad? There's one thing that annoys me. One of the things that annoys me the most is if I'm in a squad with two, you know, I'm in a full squad, four-man squad, and two of those guys are in jets. It drives me bonkers when, like, it's just the two of us trying to work as a squad. Mm-hmm. It's so hard to do. And then, you know, both of you are down, and then the only way to spawn is to back at the deployment, which is retarded. I mean, of course, if one of you are recon, you can try and get around that. But in most cases, it poses a difficult situation.
I can definitely see what you mean, but I'd say, like, when you get the people up in the jets, maybe if you're having some issues, ask them to kind of hop out of the jet, you know, and then land on a building or something, then act as a spawn point and, like, help out instead of just flying around.
Right, and that's an option, but it's, of course, that's on the fly and depending on what's happening in the battle at the time.
Yeah.
Because you definitely, if somebody's doing really well and excelling in the air and kind of giving you the advantage that way, you want to keep them up there. But at the same time, you need the force on the ground. Which brings up another thing is, I think, well, it keeps bringing up more topics, but anyways, I think that, again, going back to the four-man squad thing, the most successful squads that you see in Battlefield, and Luton will attest to it, is ones that are working together as a four-man group, whether you're on TeamSpeak or not, and can hear the whole team. At least if you four are working and really well together and communicating, and you'll do really well. And I think that we need to focus a little more as a clan, and each time that we play with each other, to start concentrating more on working together as a team, and like breaching buildings together and all that kind of stuff, watching your six, especially in, like, say, the close quarters combat. That's brought in like a whole new twist into working as a squad.
Definitely.
Like, a lot of people say that it's like running around with the, you know, chickens with their heads cut off, but if you run it as a four-man squad, you're unstoppable.
Yeah, I know that. I don't remember who said it, but I remember one of the squads is working really well as they're working even on the base conquest games, where each member is covering one direction of fire. So
mm-hmm.
on the conquest maps, I've noticed if when you're like breaching a room or you're moving from room to room, if you each watch out at an entrance of the room, because there's usually only, you know, four entrances or three entrances to the room. If each person watches one, yeah, okay. If each person watches one of the entrances as you're moving through the room, you know, you should be covered. And yeah, that's it.
All right, guys. So, well, we'll wrap it up there. Just make it. That's 15 minutes. We'll leave your thoughts, comments, and We'll try and continue to do these on a regular basis, what our thoughts are about where we're at as a clan or as a division, what have you. And that way all the members can get involved in how we develop our structure. All right. Well, thanks a lot. That's me, Dynamite. And there's Demon, Alter, and Bobby. Thanks, guys. Take care.
See ya.